start with the thymus, right? So what do you know about the thymus? This is a primary lymphoid organ. Maturation of the T lymphocyte happens in? Thymus. Maturation of B lymphocyte happens in? Bone marrow only. So what is happening if you talk about the lymphopoiesis series? So in the last class we have talked about the myelopoiesis. Myelopoiesis means including your erythropoiesis, leukopoiesis and thrombopoiesis. Remember that series? Okay, so pluripotent stem cell was there, dividing into your myeloid stem cell series and the lymphoid stem cell series. Myeloid stem cell series was responsible for the myelopoiesis, and the lymphoid stem cell series was responsible for lymphopoiesis. So if we are talking about thymus, we are considering about lymphopoiesis. Okay, so B lymphocytes and the T lymphocytes will be made over there. The thing is, B lymphocyte will already be matured in the bone marrow only, but the T lymphocyte, they will be released into the blood circulation as immature. So they will be going to the thymus, okay, and there will be the positive and negative selection of those lymphocyte, T lymphocyte, and then mature T lymphocyte will be coming out from the thymus finally. Okay, fine. So what is the significance of having mature B and T lymphocytes inside our blood circulation? Yeah, so whenever you are having some kind of infection, whenever you are some kind of bacterial or fungal viral invasion, okay, to compete with the infection, you need the lymphocyte to tackle them, right? So if, for an example, if I will be talking about the T lymphocyte, you need them to tackle the viral and the fungal infections. For the B lymphocyte, you need them to tackle the bacterial infection. Okay, for example, B lymphocyte, they will be activating the plasma cells. Plasma cell will be releasing your antibodies or immunoglobulins, right? So let's start to talk about thymus. Okay, one more thing about the thymus: as we grow older, our thymus starts to degenerate. Okay, so the thymus content will be found more in the younger age groups. Okay, and in the older age groups, it's very less, right? Okay, so about the thymus, let's say here is the thymus. Okay, here's the thymus. Thymus is having further trabeculae. Thymus is having what? Trabeculae further. Okay, radiating inwards, okay. Then you are having medulla. Shall we continue? Lot of anxiety. So I was talking about the thymus. Thymus is having two parts, cortex and the medulla. Okay, for example, if you talk about the adrenal gland, we are having adrenal cortex, adrenal medulla. Adrenal cortex is further having zones, zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata and reticularis, GFR, glomerulosa, fasciculata and reticularis. Likewise, we are having the cortex and the medulla, but here we are not having glomerulosa, fasciculata, reticularis, all those things, right? This is thymus. So if you talk about thymus, here what is this? These are trabeculae. Okay, these are trabeculae. Trabeculae are radiating inwards, okay, towards the medulla. What is the significance of having the trabeculae? They are dividing our thymus into the lobules. So this part, this is the lobules. Okay, so lobules can be found in the thymus. Okay, now this part is the cortex, this part is the medulla. Okay, now the thing is, whenever the immature T lymphocytes are coming out from the bone marrow and it is coming into the peripheral blood circulation, how do these immature T lymphocytes will know that we have to go to the thymus? Receptors, no, any other concept? The thing is, thymus releases a special kind of chemoattractant. Now, the name of this chemoattractant is thymotoxin. Okay, thymotoxin. This is kind of a chemoattractant released from the thymus, which attracts the immature T lymphocytes towards the thymus. Okay, towards the thymus. So once they will be coming towards the thymus, they will be entering into the cortex or medulla directly. Cortex first of all. So we will be having what? T lymphocytes. So in the thymus, we are having what? T lymphocytes. They are immature or mature? They are still immature. So these are the immature T lymphocytes. Right? So these are immature T lymphocytes. So what is the task of the thymus? To make them mature. Okay? With that, we are having some macrophages. We are having what? Macrophages. So I am writing with M. Okay? These are the macrophages, let's say. Okay? These are the macrophages present in your cortex or the cortical region of your thymus. Okay? We are having the macrophages. M for macrophages. Right? With that, we are having a very important cells. The name of the important cells are the nurse cells. What are these? Nurse cells. Okay? For making that easy, I am writing the N only. These are the nurse cells. Nurse cells. And here we are having macrophages. Okay? Function of macrophage? Engulfing. Engulfing what? Immature T lymphocyte, which will not be able to convert into mature T lymphocyte. So, you know, we are having two theories over here. Okay? Positive selection and negative selection. Positive selection and negative selection of what? Lymphocytes. Okay? Positive selection, for example, those lymphocytes which may convert into the mature one, for example, immature lymphocytes, which are compatible for converting into the mature lymphocytes, mature T lymphocyte, there will be the positive selection. Who will decide that? Macrophages will be deciding that. Those immature T lymphocytes which are not able to convert into mature lymphocytes, that will be the negative selection. Okay? Fine? For example, if we want to take admission in some reputed college, we need to go through some competition, right? So if you will be having the good rank, for example, you will be doing some super specialty, okay, or the specialization in any kind of course, okay, whatever it might be. So for that, you need to get some good rank. That is the positive and negative selection. Okay, if you will be getting good rank, you will be able to get admission into this college. Okay, what is this? Medulla. Okay, what is this? Cortex. Neat PG. For example, India, for US, USMLE, US, PLAB, UK, AMC, Australia, whatever is it, okay? So, the thing is, you need to go through positive or negative selection, okay? So, competition is everywhere, fine? Competition is everywhere. So, here is also the competition. So, the thing is, immature T lymphocyte has to convert into the mature T lymphocyte, okay? And macrophages helps us in positive and negative selection of that. Okay, so whatever immature T lymphocyte, they will be converting into mature T lymphocyte. Whatever lymphocyte will be present over here, okay, they pass the competition easily. Okay, fine. So they got the admission into the medulla now. Fine, they got the admission into the medulla. Now, with that, I said that we are having the nurse cells also. Right, we are having the nurse cells. These nurse cells will be helping them. These nurse cells will be helping them in passing this competition. Okay? So, nurse cells will be nursing those immature T lymphocytes. Okay? Nurse cells are helping those. Okay? So, they are like tutors. Fine? Now, what will be happening? One more kind of cell we are having over here. That is the cortical epithelial cell. Epithelial cells, these epithelial bodies, epithelial cells are present in cortex also. Epithelial cells are present in medulla also. If they are present in cortical region, we call them as cortical epithelial cells. If they are present in medullary region, we call them as medullary epithelial cells. Okay? So, over here we are having one more structure, and that is the, for example, this was cortical epithelial cell. Okay? These are the cortical epithelial cells present over here. So, cortical epithelial cells are also present in the thymus, cortex of the thymus. Over here also we are having what? Epithelial cells, but these are the cortical epithelial cells. Cortical epithelial cells. Okay, here we are having what? Which kind of cells? Medullary epithelial cells. Okay, medullary epithelial cells. Fine. So we were talking about some competition, right? So here, what is the competition to pass this exam and get the admission into the medulla, right? So the thing is, macrophages is taking that competition. Okay, so there is a positive selection and negative selection of those lymphocytes. Okay, immature and converting into the mature ones. Once that competition will be passed, you will be getting the admission into college. Okay, fine. Now there will be the super specialty. Okay, after the specialization, you will be doing the super specialization, for example. Okay, so let's say that this mature, so look, over here, there is somebody who is taking that test. Okay, super specialization test, and this is the structure which is called as Husserl corpuscles. The structure is called as Husserl corpuscles. Okay, Husserl corpuscles. However, medullary epithelial cells are giving the support to these mature T lymphocytes. Okay, so what will be happening? Whatever mature T lymphocytes over here, whatever mature T lymphocytes will be present over here. So these are the mature T lymphocyte. Okay, mature T lymphocyte. So what will be happening? This mature T lymphocyte has to go through this competition. Okay, the competition is which of the mature T lymphocyte will be compatible to tackle the infections. Okay, only those mature T lymphocytes should jump into the peripheral blood circulation. Okay, others will be again destroyed. So over here also some kind of macrophages can be present. Over here some kind of macrophages can be present. Okay, so whatever mature T lymphocyte will not be able to go into the blood peripheral blood circulation, they will be phagocytosed by this mature macrophages. Okay, macrophages. So whatever T lymphocytes, whatever mature T lymphocyte will be compatible to jump into the blood circulation and they can compete with the infection, they will be jumping into the peripheral blood circulation. Okay, so here you will be having T lymphocyte that will be matured. Okay, so that is the positive and negative selection of lymphocytes. Okay, which lymphocytes? T lymphocytes. Already B lymphocytes has been matured in the bone marrow. Okay, but for the T lymphocyte, they need to go to the thymus. By the help of thymotaxin, which is kind of a chemoattractant, they will be coming to the thymus, entering the cortex. So we are having the trabeculae inside the cortex, which is dividing the lobules inside the thymus. Over there, we are having the nursing cells, we are having the cortical epithelial cells, we are having the macrophages, we are having the immature T lymphocytes. Okay, they will be nurtured by these components over here, and then finally immature T lymphocyte will be going into the mature T medullary region, and then the medullary epithelial cells will be helping them, will be nourishing them, and finally Husserl corpuscles, okay, they will be deciding which T lymphocyte should go into the blood circulation. Okay, understood? Any problem? No. So that was about the thymus part. So yeah, cortical epithelial cells are, cortical epithelial cells are nurturing those immature T lymphocytes. They're helping to grow them. Okay. Which one? In the medullary region, they are helping them. So the, yeah, that is present in the cortex region, that is present in the medullary region. Based on the location, we named them. Okay, based on the location, we named them. However, similar kind of cells are present. It's just that they are present in the cortex, they are present in the medulla. So finally, you will be having mature B lymphocyte and mature T lymphocyte in your blood circulation. Okay, so that was about the primary lymphoid organ. So primary function is to give the mature products. Okay, so bone marrow is giving you B lymphocyte, mature B lymphocyte, and the thymus is giving you mature T lymphocyte. So that is the function of primary lymphoid organ. Now the